prior to senescence and best when the ripening before the harvesting. Respiration rate increase prior to senescence. Okay, senescence process. Before the senescence process, respiration rate is increases. And in non-climatic fruits, best when the ripening before harvest. That is called as non-climatic fruits. Examples of climatic fruits are peach, peas, mangoes, and non-climatic citrus fruits and grapes. Composition of cell wall. Pectin substances in cell wall and middle lamella start degrading due to the increased level of two enzymes. First one is the pectin esterase and second one is the polygalacturonase. Okay. Pectin in a cell wall, the pectin substances are present and in middle lamella due to the middle lamella degrading due to increase in the level of two enzymes. So the enzymes are responsible for the degrading start of fruits and vegetables. Pectic acid lost the gel forming properties. It's found in overripe, very soft fruits and vegetables. Okay, lost gel forming properties in overripe, very soft fruits and vegetables due to pectic acid. Then, on the other hand, some sugars are released from the complex polysaccharides, which results in over-sweetening of ripening fruits. Sometimes the fruit, after the harvesting of fruits, some fruits are become very sweetened after the ripening because of the, it release a sugar complex, release the complex polysaccharides. Okay, sugars are released from the complex polysaccharide. That's why some of the fruits, the taste of fruits is a very oversweetening. Then ripening of fruits. It is a genetically programmed, highly coordinated physiological process. Enzymes like lipase, invertase, chlorophyllase, pectic enzymes, and peroxidase are observed to increase at the time of ripening. Okay. Which one enzymes like lipase, invertase, chlorophyllase, pectic enzymes, and peroxidase. Change occur during the ripening. Color change, green to yellow or orange, red color. There is a breakdown of chlorophyll. Okay. Chlorophyll breakdown and change the color like green, yellow, or orange, red. Then softening of the flesh. Protopectin is converted into the pectin. After the harvesting, at the stage of ripening, most of the fruits are feel as like soft. Why? Because of the protopectin is converted into the pectin. There is a decrease in activity, increase in sugar, volatile substances and essential oils, decrease in acidity, an increase in sugar. Okay. Then harvested banana contains 20% of starch and only 1% of sugar at the time of harvesting. But after the ripening, the proportion are reversed. After the ripening, proportion are reversed. That means the starch content is reduced and sugar content is increased. Okay. Decrease in astringent properties, making a pleasant flavor. Some of the fruits having astringent properties, and the taste of fruits having the astringent taste at the time of immature fruits. So at the time of ripening, the astringency is reduced and making a pleasant flavor. The optimum temperature and humidity for a ripening are 20 degrees Celsius and 90 to 95% of humidity. Banana release ethylene gas to help itself ripening. Induce ripening of fruits. After harvesting, some fruits fail to ripen, especially bananas. So they are exposed to the ripening induced such smoke, ethylene gas, and calcium carbide. Calcium carbide pellets are used to hasten the ripening of mangoes, and banana bunches are exposed to smoke up to 12 hours for the ripening. So calcium carbide and smoke are mostly used for the hastening the ripening of fruits. The next one is the storage of fruits and vegetables. Storage is a very important part after the harvesting, as it can increase the product's shelf life and slow down the post-harvest changes in the fruits and vegetables. Only a few fruits can be stored for an extended period of time in a cold and cellular storage like apples. So the storage condition is very important for the storing of fruits and vegetables. The shelf life shelf life of fruits and vegetables is fully depends on the storage condition. So proper storage condition is very essential for the extending the period of time, storage period of horticultural produce. Each fruit has its own optimum temperature for storage and also proper air circulation ensure the successful storage of fresh fruits. Okay, in a storage condition, proper air circulation is very essential for the successful storage of fresh fruits. Then commercial storage of fruits is satisfied with temperature. Low temperature, close to 0 degrees Celsius and 85% of relative humidity. The properties of commercial storage is to maintain the low temperature from zero. Okay, 0 degrees Celsius and relative humidity is 85%. Fresh fruits absorb and emits odors. Strong flavor fruits can be stored in a tight containers. And most vegetables have a very short storage life because they're a rapid respiration. Okay, most of the vegetables having short storage life. For example, a spinach, etc. Okay, leafy vegetables because it's having a rapid respiration rate. Fresh green vegetables are kept fresh and crisp in a converted covered containers or a plastic bags in a refrigerator. Fresh green vegetables are kept in a fresh and crisp covered container or the plastic bags in a refrigerator. That means the airtight container for increasing the shelf life. Then storing in too much moisture can spoil and decay the vegetables. Okay, at the time of storing of vegetables, too much moisture can spoil the vegetables. Seeds such as peas can remain fresh longer if left in pots. Okay, peas it should be left in pots for the longer fresh condition. Okay, that peas can be stored for a longer period in a fresh condition if it is left in a pod. Peas are left in a pod. Tubers and bulbs can be stored in a cool place without refrigeration. Tubers and bulbs can be stored in a cool place without refrigeration. To extend the storage life of a perishable and semi-perishable of food products, modified atmospheric packaging is introduced. There are different types of packaging materials are available in the market. Modified atmospheric packaging. The packaging material is also available according to the commodities. Like for example, the grape are packaged in a grape guard. Then tubers are packed in a shrink package. Okay, so that can be extend the shelf life of vegetables or fruits. One more method for storing is to adjust the permeability of the packaging to match the respiration of the fruits, vegetables. So the gases inside are optimally maintained, and this reduces the rate of respiration, inhibits the synthesis, and retards microbial growth. Packaging material is very important because it can affects on the inhibits the microbial growth, and also it increases the shelf life of produce. There are various factors that can affect the storage life, like loss of wet water. It affects the appearance, texture, flavor, and weight. Respiration and metabolism. Vegetables having low respiring commodities having a long shelf life compared to high respiring commodities. So some of the vegetables having a low respiring rate, some of the vegetables having moderately respiring rate, and some of having high respiring rate. For example, low respiring rate is very low respiring rate is potato and onion. So that's vegetables can be stored for a longer period without a refrigeration condition. Okay. Because it's having very very low respiring rate. Next one is the low respiring rate, carrot, celery, and cabbage. Moderately respiring cauliflower, lady finger, and high respiring rate, broccoli, pod pea, and sweet corn. Microbial spoilage, vegetables are susceptible to the action of variety of microorganisms, thereby leading to substantial decay losses during the post-harvest handling. Microbes or the microbial spoilage are very vegetables are very susceptible to the action of microorganism. Okay, for example, decay loss during the post-harvest handling. So this is all about the biochemical and physiological changes after the harvesting of fruits.